of you might know that I whine and complain an awful lot about diabetes. So I've been pretty sick with it, with extreme lows and extreme highs. So I went to see Dr. Diabetes last week, and he suggested a freestyle Libre. Okay, so we got one. First, the insurance company rejected it. They said, that's a medical device. We don't cover medical devices. Okay. Well, then I called Medicare, you know, old people stuff. And they said, you don't meet the criteria. You need to be taking insulin like 3 or 4 times a day, or a pump or something, which I don't. So then I went to GoodRx, which gives you coupons for lots of medicines. And they did have a coupon for this one for some coinage off. But when we went to the pharmacy, our pharmacist said, I have a coupon that's better than that. I just found it. So I had to pay. I can't see that, can you? It was $150 for the reader and the sensors, two sensors. A sensor lasts for 14 days. Now, I got this yesterday, and I'm just sitting here watching videos, and there's so many conflicting things about Freestyle. There's a 10-day one, and this is the new one, the 14-day one. So we're going to start here, and got my magnifying glass very ready because I'm pretty sure I won't be able to read the directions. Oh, this is the reader. The reader enables you to scan over the device, the sensor. It's a little round thing that sticks on your arm. It's about as big as a quarter. You scan over it and it gives you a reading. You can scan it every 60 seconds and get a reading. It records every 60 seconds what you do. I mean, it's really amazing. Well, what would you rather do? Stick your finger 120 times a month or more, plus take your shots? Or would you rather just stick your arm once every 14 days and not have to stick your fingers, unless you're curious? Me, I bruise on my fingertips, so I don't want to stick them anymore. All right, so here's the reader. So I guess we open that first. Little books. This one's not my language, so I don't need that. Too much junk cluttering up the place. What is this? Interactive tutorial. Can you see it? I don't think so. This is, I don't know what it is. We'll open it later. And, oh, a big book to confuse you even more. Oh, that one's in Spanish or something. All right. Yep. Quick reference guide. That's for me. So it's a little booklet that tells you how to install your apparatus to your body and how to use it. Okay, so that's good. Here's the doohickey. Oh, it's bigger than a glucometer, my glucometer, and it's smaller than a cell phone. What do I think? I think this is nifty. Why do I think this is nifty? Because it is also a glucometer. So if you're so inclined to stick your finger, you can stick your test strip in there and get a reading. Now, this will record internally for, I think it records up to 30 days. And you can also add notes to it. So that's what you want to do. Turn it on. Maybe. It's supposed to come right on. Oh, there we go. Can you see it? Let's see, can I focus you better? English or Espanol? English. I have enough trouble with English.
Okay. Current date, 25 Feb. Next. Next. Current time,
2:01, 2:06. Let's see, I have 2:05 up there, so.
Every clock in my house is different. Next. Next. Oh, my blood range. Now, this is for, you want to enter your low value, the lowest you should be going, and then your high value, the highest your blood glucose, your blood sugar should read. I'm sorry, I can't get you clear on this. Okay, so I have been having very dramatic fluctuations. So we're going to put in high value for a low. I'm going to put in 50. I actually start feeling sick about 90. But maybe I'll go to 60. Come on, come on. When it gets down to 60, my vision is like really shot. It's like looking through a kaleidoscope. And when I get down to 40, I'm like a drunk. I mean, I've not ever been drunk, but I would imagine that's like a drunk. All right, so 150, 70 to 150. Now, on my lows, I have been down to 39 in the past year. And on my highs, I've been up to 280 something or other. That is not as bad as I have been. When I first was diagnosed with diabetes back in the mid-80s, I was hitting so high, my meters were breaking. They kept replacing my meters because they said they'll test to 550, and I was breaking them. And I didn't have to eat a thing to do that. I could have fasted all night long, and bingo, I've got those. All right, so next. Next. Now, these little arrows will tell you what your blood sugars are doing. It's rising too fast, it's rising, it's changing slowly, it's falling, or it's falling quickly. So, just so you know, gosh, it's so hard to hold. Just so you know your trend. Whoops, next. If you see this symbol, do a blood glucose test before making treatment decisions. That would mean weird blood sugars. If the sensor glucose reading does not match how you feel, do a blood glucose. If you're feeling like, if for me, I will start getting very itchy around 100. I mean, horribly skin itchy. And then the lower it goes, when it gets in the 90s and lower, I will have a very bad vision. And the lower I go, the more kaleidoscoping my eyes are doing. I do have the beginnings of glaucoma, so cataracts too, but they're immature cataracts, so we're not worrying about them at the moment. When I get way down, though, it's just horrible the way I feel. I walk into the walls, I'll pass out, I'll fall asleep. So this is good for me. Now, this tells you that the sensor can only be applied to the back of your upper arm. I've seen people putting them on all sorts of body parts, but I follow the rules. If it says the back of your upper arm, that's what I'm going to do. So, on my bum arm, my deformed arm that has all the nerve damage and broken bones and surgeries and stuff, I could never make that maneuver. So I saw a video from Canada, Hey Pharmacy, so you want to go look at that. And one of the pharmacists just pointed his elbow up to the sky and slapped that sucker on. So that's what I'm going to do. I can do that. All right, and then while using the mute reader, press the home button to return to the home screen. That's the home button. It's the only button on the meter. That little blue dot. Okay, done. Start a new sensor. Okay, that's our next step. So it will set the date and all that jazz. You can set your sounds by hitting the little gear. Sounds. Hi. I'll just leave everything the way it is. Why? Because I can't see it that well. And here's your different settings, your sounds, the target range. No. Didn't we set that already? No. Oh. That's just telling me. It's not telling me to do it. And to control, when you get a meter, a lot of them require controls. And you put this little liquid on your test strip and you stick it in. And then you do a blood sugar and you stick it in and it'll tell you how close they are to each other. And the meter can be calibrated that way. This one, you can just stick the test strip in and do a reading. Well, I guess it's not going to go, huh? Okay. And then this button here will review. Well, won't show you. It'll give you your logbook, so no more handwriting. Your daily graph. It shows your fluctuations and times. And your average glucose for the day. So this is helpful for your hemoglobin A1C. When I started with diabetes, I think I was 14. What? Yep, I was 14. When I started going to Dr. Diabetes, Dr. D for short, I was 10.4. So I was still pretty uncontrolled. Now I am down to 8.0. And I think it's because I was doing so many different reviews. Okay, let's see. So you get a daily graph. Oh, maybe they'll show you. There's no data. Okay. Daily graph. There's no data. Okay. Average glucose. Well, I don't have any data. And then it shows your patterns, your time that you've remained in your target range, and your low events, which is what Dr. D is really worried about for me, and usage. See, but there's no data, so we're not looking at that. Okay, is that it? I think we hit it all. Time, date, language. Okay, it also, up in this corner, if I can ever find it, it'll tell you how many days your sensor is good for. Remember, they're only 14 days. All right, so let me stop this video, and I'm going to start the one on the sensor. This is a USB reader. That's what it was that I couldn't see, but magnifying glasses, they help. So what I will do is open it and put this little doohickey in my USB port, and it'll be an interactive tutorial. Pretty cool. Look at this awesome quick start. It's written in big letters so you can read it. It tells you all the stuff we pretty much did, but how to start the new sensor with the reader and how to check your glucose, blah, 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 understanding your glucose readings and reviewing your history. So this would make it super easy for an idiot like me. Okay, let's see. How to set it up, how to apply your sensor. Here's the sensor. Let's open it. Oh, it was already open. How about that? Ooh. There's one. Here's two. Here's alcohol. Here's Spanish directions. We actually started to learn Spanish when we lived in Africa because the lady that ironed for my mother was Spanish. We didn't keep her too long, though. She was ridiculously slow. My mother was getting nervous. Okay, shows you how to apply it. But like I said, I'm not going to do the cross body one because I'm going to do the bent elbow one. Because it's just, I'm deformed in areas. All right, so I got two of these. This one will be used in 2 weeks. First thing you do when you're getting ready to apply is check the code on the back of the containers. And make sure they match. And they do, but you can't see it because I could barely see it. And I even use my magnifying glass. Don't they know people with diabetes have something called retinopathy? I've been a diabetic for a long time. My number one little brother is also a diabetic. He's pretty sick right now. Now, you peel the doodad off. Ugh. This is... That's what it looks like. Now there's a dark line right here. So I'll take my cooking sweater off. Comes with alcohol wipes. Take one, just one. I'll rip it open. Gee, these are skimpy. I'm gonna put it on my so-called good arm, which is still not a good arm. Just alcohol off your arm. And you want to make sure that you let the alcohol evaporate. Let it be dry. Give it a good scrub. Because it's going to be on your arm for two weeks. Okay, so I'll save that one. I think that this one might be to get the residual adhesive off your arm. Because from what I've seen, it's pretty nasty. But I have a better way. I'll show you that later. Okay, so now you got your applier, and now you wanted to get your sensor out of here. I didn't do this with Hungry being home because I didn't. And that's what the inside of the sensor, this part's going to be on your body, so. There's a coil in there, a spring, because it's just like your finger sticker. It's going to be, you know, wow, ejected on you. Now, everybody says it's a big needle. It's not the big needle. There's a needle in there, but it doesn't stay in you. It's just to facilitate putting this little catheter thingy in. And it's very tiny and it shouldn't hurt one bit. If it hurts as much as a finger stick, well, I can deal with that. Okay, so put that down there and you find the dark mark right there and the dark mark right there. See? See? Dark. And the dark. Line them up. See? Lined up. Boom! Now it's empty. And now that's not. You can see the needle? It freaks people out. Are you kidding me? I've had more needles than that embedded in my mitral valves. 11 of them. Okay. So now what you do is you put it against your dehydrated upper arm. How can I do this? I guess I can't. Anyway. Can you see? Make sure it's in there. And it didn't hurt. Hey, it is. I did it. Where are you? See? It's sticking right there. Can you see? I can't twist anymore. Okay, that's good enough. Push it on. I feel like a little, I can feel something, but it's not anything that I would consider painful. And if I had to do this 3 times a day, I would have no problem doing this three times a day. Not at all. Okay, so clean this mess up and then we'll be back. Okay, get your giant directions out to see how to start this thing to work. Okay, start new sensor, turn it on, and then click start new sensor. Okay, scan the sensor to start it. Well, I'm not going to try and do this again, am I? Okay. And now when 60 minutes is up, I can start doing my blood sugars. Isn't this exciting? Hungry will be impressed that I didn't have to call him at work 75 times to help me. While we're waiting for our 60 minutes to be up, I want to talk to you. You might say, Duddie, how the heck are you going to live that thing on your arm for 14 days? Well, you can exercise when you have it on. Fat chance will get me doing that. You can take a shower. You can take a bath. You can go swimming, but you can't get this lower than 3 feet. Not at all. So it's best not to go deep sea diving or any of that. You cannot wear it when you go through the x-ray machine at the airport. Nope, you can't. You got cracked your head open? No CAT scans. No, you can't do it. Going to the dentist? No x-rays. No x-rays at all. So, well, what if you have to have these things done? You got to take it off. Or ask for, is there another method? Like at the airport, you could choose to be, like, physically touched rather than walk through the naked body thing. But I'm not getting on an airplane ever again in my entire life. So I don't care. I mean, you'll care if you travel, but I can't see that I have any more travel days left in me unless it's a short trip in the car to the doctor or the dentist or something like that. If my friends want to see me, they know where I live. Okay. So, since none of this stuff is covered by insurance, it's pricey. So I have 57 and a half minutes to go, and then we'll be back with our very first reading. It's going to be so weird not lugging all that stuff around with me. I only have to lug this around with me. I don't have to carry test strips and needles and glucometers and pokers and my notebook, because when you have to log as much information as I do, those little notebooks that they give you, they're called logbooks, that the doctor gives you, it's not enough room to write down what you were doing when you had this low, mostly sleeping. What were you eating when you had that high? Probably tea. I don't know. It's a whole new freedom. When I started using the Freestyle Light, which is a very small meter, I was thrilled. In fact, when the insurance wouldn't pay for it anymore, I almost went ballistic. But then I remembered, Scruffy had one. So I got a lot of testing materials from Scruffy when she passed away. I sure do miss my little dog. If anybody has a spare Toy Fox Terrier female tricolor puppy, mail them to me, please. Mail her to me, please. Okay, so there we go. We'll see what it is. It's 2:35 almost, and I did not eat yet. I got up early this morning. I was having Lowe's. I had some emergency because I take vitamin C every day. Now that is, I think, the orange junk that you eat or take the tablets, I think that they do change your blood sugars. So you might want to research that pretty much. Okay, so far there were two people, and I watched a lot of reviews, a lot of videos, a lot of information. Two people that didn't like this system. One of them refused to use the sensor on the correct body part because it would show and ruin the outfit. And another one liked a different system better. But she calibrated, I think, in a strange way, which made her readings way off. She was testing both the Freestyle 14-day or 10-day, I think she had, against her other reader and a finger stick. And the finger stick and the other reader were closer together. But she calibrated her machine to be with that meter she was using. So who knows? She might be right. She might be wrong. Why am I making such a long video? I have not found a video yet that answered all the questions that I'm answering for you. And it took me since yesterday to get the information. My USB. There we go. My hour is up. Okay. So let's look at the big giant directions again. Check your glucose. Step one, turn it on. Oh. Scan. Okay, hold the reader within 1.5 inches or 4 centimeters or centimeters, depending on where you live, of the sensor to scan it. Okay, so I timed out because I didn't do it fast enough. But that's okay, because I'm going to take off my kitchen sweater. Although, you can do this through your jacket, your sweater, your pajamas, your anything. Okay. Check glucose. And here we go. 174. Okay. So I went back and looked at my numbers, and when I woke up after about 2 hours of sleep, I was 94, which is pretty good. And then I'm still fasting, by the way. It's 3:30 in the afternoon. I'm still fasting. So it was 94, and then the next time I took it, still fasting, with just a cup of tea in me with lemon juice, a little piece of lemon, and stupid tea kettles going. And, whoops, some Splenda. And it was 111, so it was on the rise. I have one of those weird situations. Anyway, so now I'm still fasting, and it's 3:33 in the afternoon, I think, and it's 174. So obviously what I'm eating is a Zippo since 1 o'clock this morning, this morning, and I'm rising. So this is gonna get put into my little notes too. Anyway, it was so easy, no finger sticks. I can do it all I want. Really happy with that. Oh, look. Here's another thing. See the arrow? It's saying I'm going down. But it's not changing rapidly. It's not like straight. The arrow's not pointing straight down. So, anyway, yeah, I like this. I really do. I'll check it again. It must be a minute, right? Look at that. It's 188 and steady. Let me think about that. 188 fasting. Huh. Well, that's interesting. Be aware of your numbers and what you were doing when your numbers hit those highs and lows. Well, all I did was make this video. I didn't eat anything, just tea with a squeeze of lemon and Splenda. I'm gonna check it every minute for the rest of my life. 198, still fasting. Okay, let's try this. Now, $165, $209. Time to call Abbott. Who's Abbott? People that make these things. Okay. After I had the 209, I decided to wait a little bit. I ate a sandwich. It was my first meal since 1 a.m. And this was at 3:15 p.m. or 3:30 p.m. And then after I ate the sandwich, usually I'll do my blood sugars about a half an hour after, which I think it was. And yeah, it was more than a half an hour later. And my blood sugar's dropping after eating. That's very weird. Now I'm going to take my insulin, so we'll see what happens. Okay, so reading around in the bottom of the box, there's two booklets with even more detailed instructions. And here's my charger thingy. So, and the plugger inner. Okay. Now, with the reader, is also a way you can use your smartphone, but I can barely make phone calls on mine, like I said. So I'm not gonna try and do that. I'd rather have the separate reader because it's logging everything and it's downloadable and a smartphone isn't. Okay. My problem with the blood sugars would be that Duddie. I did not take my insulin because I just didn't take my insulin until very late in the day. So, we'll see. I'm going to give it 24 hours before I start freaking out. So, we'll see what happens tomorrow. Okay, this is 2 weeks. Where are you? Okay, can you see that thing on my... Okay, that's the doohickey that actually read your blood sugars. I banged it so many times. Ow, ow, ow. Ooh. Oh, it hurts. Oh, I should have let Hungry do this. I can't get it off. I'm such a tender old lady. Ooh, that hurts. Ooh, I got blanket fuzz, nightgown fuzz, sweater fuzz. Is that disgusting? Easy way to get it off. You won't believe this. The bean, my oldest daughter, one time fell asleep
after my brother gave her 50 pounds of saltwater taffy and it was in her hair. Everybody's saying, you'll have to cut her hair off. No. Peanut butter. So I'm going to rub peanut butter on that. I don't know if you can see. I got a welt, but I do have a sensitivity to adhesives, but there's a welt, definitely. Plus, yesterday, well, I'll tell you, I'm like 5 feet tall, and it's hard for me to get in and out of the washing machine and get the wet clothes out, because I can only use my right arm to do that. And as I was dangling with my feet up in the air in the washing machine, I yanked out a pair of Hungry's work pants, uniform pants, and banged my arm on the side of the drum. Not once, not twice, 3 times. I thought, oh my gosh, I ripped my skin off. Okay, so here's the thing. I'm trying to focus, but I'm not very good at it. I'm going to do it this way. Can you see the needle? It's not all that big. It's a little bit bolder, I'd say, than a I'm trying. Trust me, I'm trying. There we go. It's a bigger needle than, I mean, thickness-wise. It's bigger than the insulin pen. And bigger than the finger sticker. But honestly now, how many times do you stick your finger a month? I have a minimum of 120 sticks a month. You know, that's ridiculously a lot. I'd rather do stick my arm, this in my arm, 2 times a month than 120 plus a month. Okay, I'm going to turn you off while I get the other one ready. And I've come to a decision on that one. Dispose of it with my needles. I'm going to put the next one on my bad arm. I mean, my incredibly bad arm. They're both bad arms, but my incredibly bad arm. I don't like to put anything even close on that arm. They hurt, my arm hurts so much. And I can't have my blood pressure taken on my good arm, my good bad arm, if I have a device on it. So it's got to go on the left arm, the one that has all the injuries to it. They can't use a tourniquet on that arm for my monthly labs. They can't use the blood pressure cuff on it. It's too painful. So my right arm is the one that I had the hickey-do on, and I'm going to switch it over to the back of my busted arm. I know it's going to hurt. I know it's going to hurt taking it off. Okay. So here goes nothing. I can't open it. Oh. The first thing you do, like we showed you in the beginning, I open them backwards. Jeepers. First thing I have to do is open them. Don't fall on the floor. Oh. Always check the numbers on the labels to make sure that they match. You didn't get oddball parts. Okay. I need to get my thing. Forgot to turn you on. What I was doing is alcohol wipe the back of my busted arm. They give you two of these. I'm assuming one of them is to help you get off the glue. So you just, like I showed you in the beginning, line these two things up, press firmly, and there you go. Big giant needle sitting there. Just wait until your alcohol evaporates on your arm and then stick it on. I'm not going to show you sticking it on because I don't want to. It's important that you let the alcohol dry. This is my cookbook chair I'm using. I have piles of cookbooks. I have them on the floor all around the chair, stacked up in some sort of disorder. I like this book. I can't figure out with the Freestyle Libre. I have something called eCare, and it is a direct connection to all my doctors. I try to stay in a certain health system and don't like to venture out of it because you know all that paperwork you fill out when you go to a new doctor? It's already filled out for you. So, I can... Well, Dr. Diabetes wants me to mail him, or e-care him, my numbers, my charts, and my reports at least every 2 weeks. And today is 2 weeks that I've been using this machine. And I'm going to have such a trouble trying to get a PDF file that big attached to an e-care mail. It's really bugging me. Okay, I'm going to stick this on the back of my arm. Don't look. Oh my God, it hurts. The arm hurts, not the injection. It's on. Okay, so now I'm going to wait an hour or two and take my blood sugars again.